As you can see, I already went ahead and I made the rest of the landmarks, but now we are going to make some greens.
First off, you're going to start with layers and you want to make a new layer. And that one I'm going to call greens. And next up, you can add a new artboard, or you can do what I do and go to artboard tool. And you can draw your own artboard. In this case, I'm going to draw a small one because we're not going to make that many bushes and shrubs and trees. I'm going to place this one over here. And then we are going to start with the orange tree. I've chosen the ellipse tool while holding Alt and Shift, but make sure you draw it in the right layer. So in the greens layer, and I'm going to give it green fill color, and I'm going to draw the stem. And a brown stem to the back, and I'm going to draw some oranges on top. Select everything, press Command G to group, and we're on to the next one. The next tree, I'm going to use rounded rectangle tool and click and drag. So you got the shape, and this one is going to be darker green. Again, the stem. And to the back. And again, group. We are making some bushes and shrubs. And I'm going to select the ellipse tool. And I'm going to draw some circles in different sizes. Just like this. Select the rectangle tool. And make sure that at the beginning there's one circle to hide the edge of the rectangle. And they all have to overlap a bit. So this is one shrub, and then we will go to Pathfinder Unite. And you can give it a fill color. We are going to make another one. It's the same technique, the same thing. This one's going to be a bit smaller. And again, select Unite. Next up, I'm going to draw an oval. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to select the direct selection tool by using shortcut A, or you can click on direct selection tool over here. Select this anchor point, and while holding shift, drag the handlebars in to create a leaf type of shape. And I'm going to drag it out a bit. So copy this one. While holding shift, turn it into a 45 degree angle and place all the points together. The same you do on the other side. Yeah, it's not too bad. And again, unite. This one is going to be a lot smaller. And it might be nice to draw another shrub, but maybe with star tool. This, and we are going to stretch it out. And let's see if I turn it into an angle. Might be nicer if it's a bit smaller even.
and copy that and do it on the other side as well. And again, unite. So up until so far, we've got these trees. What I want to make now is one big tree. I'm going to use the rectangle tool. And turn these anchor points in. This is going to be a stem. Right now, I'm going to use the, let me see, the line tool, line segment tool, and I'm going to draw the branches of the tree. We are going to swap fill stroke, and we're going to change the stroke weight to 4. Go to stroke here on the right side, and make sure that you have a rounded cap. Draw the branches randomly. They go up and they go down. I'm going to make this one a bit smaller. Okay, I think I'm almost there. What I'm going to do now is that I'm going to select everything. Object, expand, OK. And unite, not just yet. Going to click on the ellipse tool and change the color to a bit lighter, maybe same type of green as I've got over here. And place this on the branches, but don't make it too big. So this is going to be the first layer. And just place it randomly. What we're going to do now, we're going to take one of those and we make that one a bit darker with the ellipse tool. And we are going to place that on top. So this is going to be the big tree, and select everything and group. And what I'm going to do now, we're going to make a couple of palm trees. There are different ways of making palm trees, but I'm just going to do the same what I did with the other one. And that was going with the ellipse tool, shortcut A for direct selection tool, and pull these handlebars in. And we are going to create the stem. And I'm going to turn this anchor point a bit further in. So it's just click and drag. From here, I'm going to put it on top. And copy them, paste, right click, arrange, nope, that's not true, transform, reflect, vertical, okay. Yeah, that looks a bit strange. Down. It's not going to be exactly the same. This one up top, wow, it's quite an eccentric one. Maybe if I make it smaller. That looks a bit better. I'm just going to group it, and just in case, I'm going to make another one because it's not the most beautiful one. And right now, I'm going to use the pen tool.
and I'm going to draw the leaves on top. So I made my first anchor point in the middle of the tree, and now I set another one, and I'm pulling the handlebars to the side to create a curve. When I let loose, the curve will flow. To click, that means that the curve is not going to continue. Then I'm going to close a shape, but pulling in a certain direction to create the leaf image. And just to give it a quick color. This could be one option, but I'm still not happy about this. Add another anchor point and drag this one out. Turn it a bit. Going to do the same for the other side. So each leaf is going to be different from the other one. And what you would like to do is you like to hide the beginning of the stem. So make sure that every point is aligned. Maybe a bit more like this. So you don't really see the beginning or end of each leaf, and especially of the stem. Okay, that's going to be the palm tree. So for now, we've got a couple types of trees, and we're going to use it to fill the map.